What's going on, everybody? It's Extreme Card Breaks. Today, I've looked this up. This is going to be a YouTube record. We're going to be opening up 320 packs of 1989 Donruss Baseball. Yes, 320 packs. This may take a little bit to do, but we're going to do it. We're going to go hunting for that perfect PSA 10 Ken Griffey Jr. rookie card out of it. Odds of pulling it, very slim. The via PSA 10, but we're out to look for it. So, as you can see up here, my top camera, right up there, that's what 320 packs looks like. This is the front view of it all. It's all there, guys. This is going to be insane. I'm going to try to go as quick as possible into the video. As always, I thank you all for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Give the video a thumbs up so you guys are notified whenever we're going to go live or post a new video. I can tell you now, we got a lot of stuff coming in. I'm still working on the store, so bear with me. But real quick, I want to give a shout out to this Facebook group where I won this at. They do all kinds of cool stuff in there. It is called the House of Vintage and Junk Era Card / Memorabilia. There will be a link down in the description, so make sure you go ahead and click on it. Join the group. They do razzes. They do sales. There's trading that's going on in there. They do weekends to where anything, you can list anything basically on there. I don't want to say anything goes because then people start getting sketchy onto it, but it's something like that in a way. But you don't have to stick to the vintage or junk era cards onto. You can go with newer if you want. It's a great group. They do have a good set of rules that you need to look at, though, because it keeps everybody in check. And that's what you want when you get in these Facebook groups, is to be in check. Basically, we got all these very, very cheap in a raz. So let's get to opening. Don't forget, there'll be a link in the video below. All right, I'm going to push this other one back over on the big screen, guys. We're getting ready to do 320. I don't know how many Griffeys we're going to pull. I don't know how many Sheffield, Smoltzes, all that. But we're going to give it a shot and see what can happen. Like I said, these guys here, they go out, they buy out collections and stuff, then they put the stuff up. So we're going to give it a shot, see what we can pull out of this. There's going to be tons and tons of cards here. I'll try to keep stacks going so at the end we can kind of see where we're at. Might have been a bad idea wearing some gloves for this for once, but we'll see what we can do. So hopefully a pretty good week. As some people already know, I got a different job at work, promotion, so we're trying to see where things go next week with the hours and everything. Oh, gosh. That just shot right out at me. All right in my hand, though. But be prepared for some changes. Make sure that he's going the right way. All but one or two. But with the times of doing stuff, I'm kind of excited to do this. Nobody's ever opened. This is basically just shy of 12 boxes. 12. Boxes from the junk era. So pretty excited on this. Donruss this year, it was massively produced. I'm going to tell you guys something. By looking at all the stuff from the 80s being open, it's going to be gone one day. And then you can just see what the price is going to be, because everybody's opening it. They're all trying to chase these PSA 10s from it. And I can tell you, I think personally, PSA is very hard on some of on the 10s now compared to what it was. So what I like doing, I see how many total cards have been submitted. Now, I'm not saying this is the way to do it or anything like that. But what I do is I take a percentage. How many PSA 10s are out there? Griffey's, I think it's something like stupid, like 3%. So, I mean, when you look at astronomically, say there's like 10,000 of them have been graded, you're talking a small percentage. So why these things are so hard to get. The people would have this stuff laying in their garages. And now all of a sudden you're seeing it pop out every which way. So if you can get it cheap and you want to open it, go for it. To me, just loose packs, I'm going to open her. I'm going to go for it. Just like we're doing today. All right, we'll do one more pack here. We'll start going through these. I do apologize. You guys can skip to the end of the video if you want to. And you can see what the overall results are. All right, I'm going to move this stack kind of down just so I can go through this. Alrighty here. My green whale. As you guys know, we opened a box of this a while back, probably a couple weeks ago. We had pulled one Griffey, which isn't unheard of. Eric Hansen. Good old Bo. We'll put Bo off to the side. Bo was a good guy. Yeah, I got a big storage box behind me on this stuff. Chris Sabo. Man, everybody chased it one time. Just dropped off the earth. Now, I'm not going to say there's not going to be, like, no other PSA 10s into this. It's just that, you know, the ones that are sought after is what we're looking for. And as I clear off, you'll hear me behind me dumping these into a big, huge monster box. I got somebody who does card lots. I'm sure he's going to hate life when he sees this. It's going to be like, are you serious? You really opened that much of 89 Donruss? I can't remember if somebody connects Seiko or not. I'm just going to put it over there in the pile. Ricky Jordan. Believe it or not, this dude was so popular back in 89, everybody wanted Ricky Jordan. If I get the camera to focus back onto her. A little bit of shine there. I don't know why. But yeah, he was super popular. I know a lot of you guys remember this stuff. Wally Joyner, MVP. Pretty cool card. We're going to see how many we can pull the good stuff, though, today. Like I said, I'm going to go through these pretty quickly. Just for the fact that we know what we're looking for. Greg Jeffries. I know, I'm going to say that just for somebody that hates Greg Jeffries. I might just mail them to him out of nowhere. Tell him Merry Christmas or something. So, first little stack. No Griffies. Nothing big. Basically a Bo Jackson and a lovely Greg Jeffries. So, like I said, this could be a long, long video. Oh, you can see how some of these packs, man, the wax is just, it's been there forever on these. I'm trying to go like this. That way I don't have to have the puzzle pieces. And no, I'm not keeping the puzzle pieces. They're going straight into the garbage. Somebody once asked me, what do you do with all the puzzle pieces? I don't keep them. My luck, I'll be sitting there 20 years down the road and people will be selling puzzle pieces sets for like $500. I can see it now. After this this one here, we'll be down 300 left. 300 only. I mean, seriously, how many people out there will go and open up 320 packs of Donruss to make YouTube history? This guy here. If people have asked about breaks coming up too, we're going to say I don't think there's much for the month, guys. I got like a box of Immaculate next week and a freaking like two boxes of Prism Draft. It's not worth doing a break on. I don't think there's anything we'll even come close until football jerseys come out. I'm trying to get some of this wax crud off there. Yeah, I don't know how long it takes to get this stuff cleaned up afterwards. Oh, man. I think I just inhaled like wax. At least we don't have bubble gum in all this. That's the only thing that's good. I was going to go live for this. I really was. But I know you guys would be bored out of your minds. We do a box of 86 Donruss coming in next week. We will go live with the 86 Donruss. But yeah, I was throwing this up in the air about going live with this, and I'm like, man. You guys will probably think I'm out of my mind. Alright, next stack here. Let's see what we can do. Is the Griffey laying in one of these? Some of these have had some pretty nice centerings, but it's the borders that get you, or the, yeah, I guess you can call it borders, or not corners, edges. Medina. Jose Canseco, MVP. Oh, why, that's upside down. Tommy Glavin. Should be like his second year, I believe, yep. Felix Jose, Cal Ripken MVP. You guys can see his centering on these were hard back in the day. Let's just grab to there. I don't know what is up with, here we go, with this camera today. Let me see if I kind of tilt this leg a little bit. There we go, a little better. That's your puzzle pieces from back in the day. Sabo again. Bonilla, who's still getting paid to this day. Another Tommy Glavin. Ruben Sierra. Another Ricky Jordan. So I've been doing a Griffey behind there. Kurt Schilling. Huh, just an 88 was his rookie. I thought for some reason it was 89. All right, first stack completed 20 packs. No Griffey. So far, we're sitting at a Bo and a Greg Jeffries. Not even a Randy or a Sheffield yet. Might end up ditching these gloves because I cannot dig into the wax packs at all. It's just so hard for me to grip. What am I doing? Wow. I just look at how waxy it. I mean, this stuff you could tell just been sitting. Oh yeah, they were selling these non-foods, 59 cents a pack.